If you always wanted to become a successful software developer, let me guess, you never knew where to start. But you don't have to look for other resources because this video is your ultimate guide to becoming a software developer. Before we start, like the video and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Also, check the description box for the free guideline on becoming a software developer. If you are ready, let's dive in. Why do you want to be a programmer? You need to ask this question to yourself, because it will play a significant role in your journey. You need to justify your reasons. Why do you want to be a software developer? Is it because of a career change, more money, or something else? Make your purpose clear for consistency and success. This is the first and the most important step in the guideline. In the second step, I want you to choose a field of expertise. As a computer engineer, I warn you that computer science is just as huge as an ocean. There are many fields that you can work on. Backend development, front-end development, AI and machine learning, cybersecurity, and many more. You can master it in multiple areas, but you need to be an expert of at least one field. After that, you can switch to another area if you want. This step is also very important because you will learn your first programming language. You need to choose wisely. If you're learning from scratch, I recommend that you start with something basic like Scratch. Scratch is a high-level, block-based visual programming language and website aimed primarily at children as an educational tool. Students in MIT also start to learn programming with Scratch. I will put the link for Scratch in the description box. You can check it out if you're interested. If you say that you're adult enough to start with the proper language, I suggest other programming languages. Java, Python, and C# are used widely and they're beginner friendly. Although Java is a bit harder than Python, I strongly recommend learning Java before Python because if you do so, you will be familiar with object-oriented programming, a fundamental programming concept. However, if your purpose is only for AI, machine learning, or data analytics, then Python is a no-brainer. After choosing a programming language, you need to start from somewhere. That's where the resources come to the scene. You should find the best resources you can. When I say the best, I don't necessarily mean that they have to be super expensive. No. The best resource depends on the person. You can even learn from the programming channels on YouTube. If you feel fancy, you can also buy a course online. You can buy them from Udemy or Coursera. Udemy offers various courses at affordable prices. Personally, I don't recommend purchasing a course on Coursera because the courses on Coursera are more academic rather than practical. This step is for people who want to specialize in backend or front-end development. Learning a framework is important because frameworks contain the necessary elements for developing software. There are numerous frameworks used in the industry, and it's possible to find various frameworks for each programming language. For example, Django, Flask, and FastAPI are widely used backend frameworks for Python. You need to consider the popularity of the framework before learning. Is it on demand in the industry? Is its community large? You need to answer these questions first. After learning a framework, you can easily switch to other frameworks since they're similar to each other. Okay, if you consistently apply the guidelines until here, then you know everything in theory. However, theory does not mean anything if you don't apply it in your programs. You need to build projects constantly to practice. You need to build projects even after you are an expert because computer science is an everlasting learning journey. You can never say that you are done with it. Also, try to learn from other areas if you are interested. For example, if you are a backend developer, you can also try to learn the basics of front-end development. Who knows, you may like it more than backend development. That's it. Thanks for watching my video. I value your likes and comments. Do you have any other techniques than those discussed in the video? Comment down below. Also, I really appreciate it if you subscribe to my channel for free. See you in the next video.